The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the chief priests and the elders of the people, "Hear another parable. There was a landowner who planted a vineyard, put a hedge around it, dug a wine press in it, and built a tower. Then he leased it to tenants and went on a journey. When vintage time drew near, he sent his servants to the tenants to obtain his produce. But the tenants seized the servants, and one they beat, another they killed, and a third they stoned. Again, he sent other servants more numerous than the first ones. But they treated them in the same way. Finally, he sent his son to them, thinking, 'They will respect my son.' But when the tenants saw the son, they said to one another, 'This is the heir. Come, let us kill him and acquire his inheritance.' They seized him, threw him out of the vineyard, and killed him. What will the owner of the vineyard do to those tenants when he comes?" They answered him, "He will put those wretched men to a wretched death, and lease these vineyards to other tenants, who will give him the produce at the proper times." Jesus said to them, "Did you never read in the scriptures, 'The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone'? By the Lord has this been done, and it is wonderful in his sight. Therefore I say to you, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to a people that will produce its fruits." When the chief priests and the Pharisees heard his parables, they knew that he was speaking about them. And although they were attempting to arrest him, they feared the crowds, for they regarded him as a prophet. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We started this week reminding ourselves that Christianity is an outward movement. It is not about what you receive, but what you have given. It is never about what being done to you, but what you have done to others. Tuesday, if you can still remember, we talk about the good things that must be rooted in justice. To give what is due. To give what is due. Ibigay sa higit na nangangailangan kung ano ang meron ka. What do we have last Wednesday is that regardless how good you are, you can always find people who are bad to you. You will always find people who are bad to you. That's why the exhortation is, when people are bad, be good to them because it is who you are. But when people are good to you, of course you have to be good to them. And yesterday, we talked about the rich man who failed to do what is just. As I have said, do not entertain the thought that when you are poor, automatically you go to heaven. Or when you are rich, you will go to hell. That is not the gospel is all about. The rich man went to hell because of neglect. And you and me, among the poor, automatically will go to hell also out of neglect. Father, ang hirap na nga, ano pa ang maibibigay namin? And remember the words of Mother Teresa of Calcutta, that no one is too poor that he has nothing to give, and no one is too rich that he has need nothing. And what is the gospel or the readings trying to tell us today? Do not forget this. Regardless of influence, talent, riches, name it, you will never have what it is not for you. You will never have what it is not for you. The first reading speaks of brothers selling their own brother out of jealousy. Out of jealousy. What is the gospel trying to tell us? The tenants who tries to own what is simply being leased to them. Nakakapagod mang sabihin ito, pero magandang palagi ipinapaalala na dumating tayong walang dala, aalis tayong walang dadalhin. Sayang naman ang biyayang pinagkaloob sa iyo ng Diyos na hindi mo ginamit itong tama. I remember someone sent a message that there was or there is an injustice with regard to the share of inheritance. Sabi niya, nung binata naman ng kuya ko, mabait naman yan. Ngayon nag-asawa na, hindi namin maintindihan kung bakit nagkaganon. Nagpamana ang aming magulang ng ari-arian at ito ay pinagbili para aming paghati-hatian. Alam po naming magkakapatid na ang napagbilhan ay 24 million pero ang napunta lang sa akin ay 1. Hindi ko na inusisa kung ano nangyari. Ano po? Naalaala ko tuloy yung kwento, yung karanasan na may magkapatid na nag-aaway dala ng kapirasong lupa. Nadinig na ito ng iba na kung saan nag-imbita pa ng pari na mag-mediate. Ha? Na kung saan walang ginawa kundi magbangayan sa harapan ng lamesa. Ano po? Hindi naman nakapagsalita ang pari kasi sila-sila lang ang nagtatalo. Ano po? Dumating pa yung misis, lalong gumulo. Sorry, ano po? Pagkamisan yun ang problema eh, no? May mga taong dapat makatulong, lalong gumugulo. Away ng away. Ha? Inaamin ko, nasabi ko yan, inabot na kami ng gabi, nagutom na ako. Ano po? Hindi ka lang pinagsalita, binigyan ka ng kape. Ano po? Puro kape lang, wala man lang biskit. Hindi ba? Ano? Ha? Nag-asim na yung tiyan mo. Kaya yung katulong nung naghahanda na ng pagkain, o naghahanda na ng lamesa doon sa aming kakainan, tinitingnan ko talaga kung anong ilalagay. Sabi ko, oy, may malaking bowl, may sabaw, di ba? Ano? Nag-i-imagine na kayo. Pero, dala ng gutom para matigil na tinanong ko sa magkakapatid, ako ba'y pwede magsalita? Ano? Sabi, oy, Father, kayo po, kanina pa po namin kayo inaantay. Huh? Kunwari, no? Para lang matapos, sabi ko, alam po ninyo, yung pinagdadaanan yung pinagtatalunan yung lupa, hindi nyo naman madadala sa impyerno yan. Sabi ng isang kapatid, bakit naman sa impyerno, Father? Sabi niya, bakit? Sabi ko, aasa kayo makakarating kayo sa langit, sa kapirasong lupa na hindi nyo naman madadala. Alam nyo, pinalis ako, di ako pinakain. Ano po? Ha? Mga minamahal na mga kapatid, as I say this always, if you commit injustice, you will pay for it. Ang sagot ko lamang doon sa mga nanglalamang sa kapwa, lalong-lalo na sa magkakapatid, yung perang nakuha ninyo sa hindi tamang pamamaraan, mauubos lang yan kababayad ng utang o kababayad ninyo sa hospital dala ng inyong karamdaman. We have a God of justice. You will never own what is not meant for you. You will never own what is not meant for you. What is 20 silver pieces of silver? Ano magagawa niya sa iyo? Sa kapatid na pinagbili mo o sa Diyos na pinagkanulo mo? My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, as I have said this many times, the problem of betrayal, it is not done to you by your enemies. The problem of betrayal is always done to you by your friends and, sad to say, by your own brothers and sisters. And this is the grace we would like to ask from the Lord. Spare us, O Lord, in this greedy attitude, forgetting we came with nothing, we leave with nothing. Amen. Today, First Friday, we will have a benediction at 5 o'clock in the afternoon. It will be done already in the church. Starting tomorrow, our masses again will be in the main church. Thank you for your patience. Thank you for joining with us in this time. Ano po? I would like to make an appeal for those who are watching us online. Do not forget to share, or for those who have not been or have not clicked the button follow, kindly click the button follow. Ano po? Or those who are watching us in YouTube, kindly click the button subscribe. Why am I making this appeal? Because I have noticed lately yung mga hindi ko maintindihan kung bakit nila hinahide yung ating mga misa. Ano po? I think yesterday or 2 days ago, 486 people hide our mass. 480, galit na galit sila, ano? I mean, they deleted our mass. So there's no way for you to see it. There are few numbers who hide the page itself, everything. You cannot find everything because they have hide it. So ano pong ating gagawin dyan? I ask that you do your part. Kindly click follow, then share. Ano po? To compensate those who are hiding our Eucharistic celebration. Binabati ko po yung 35 hanggang 52. Ano po? Anong 35? Hindi po yan edad. Meron pong palaging angry face. Pagka minsan, 35, mataas 52. Tinitingnan ko, pagka minsan, pare-pareho mukha nila. Papangit kayo. Ano po? Palagi kayong angry. Hindi ko naman maintindihan kung bakit kayo nakikinig ng misa at kayo nagagalit. Ano po? Anyway, well, talagang ganyan din si Herodes eh, ano? Galit na galit kay Juan. Pero ayaw na maipapatay, galit lang. Ha? Wala kayong kahihinatnan, pero siguro talagang natatouch kayo, ano? Hipuinawa ng Diyos ang inyong mga puso. Ha? Yung mga magka-classmate na angry bird, ano po? Angry people, ano po? Kilala ko kayo. Kilala ko mga pangalan nyo. Nakikita ko. Ano po? Ha? Anyway. Muli. Wala akong kinabukasan niya kasi pagagalit. Ano po? Again, ano po? Ang aming pasasalamat sa lahat ng tumutulong for your love offerings, especially for our apostolate. may the Lord return it to you a hundredfold. Going back to what I've said, ano po, as we closes the week for our second week of Lent meditation, remember that we will be judged by what we do, because Christianity is an outward movement. And the good things we do not forget that you have to do it with justice, to give what is due. And regardless how good you are, there are people who will be bad to you. But be good, because it is who you are. Yesterday, don't neglect your obligation to help those who are in need. And today, do not forget, you will never own what is not meant for you. Kung kayo ay nandadaya, babayaran nyo yan pagdating ng araw. Kung hindi man kayo, ang mga anak ninyo, yung mga perang kinuha nyo, ari-arian, yan ay babawiin sa inyo. Either through your sickness, o pagkalugi, o mababaong kayo sa utang. Huwag nyo nang antayin yan. Ano po? Huwag nyo nang antayin. Doon siya nagsabing, Father, baka naman kaya binigay 1M lang kasi that is what due. Excuse me. Pagpamana, the intention of the donor must be respected. Ang intention ng inyong mga magulang, hati-hatiin yan ng equal. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Grant your people, O Lord, we pray, health of mind and body, that by constancy in good deeds, they may always merit the defense of your protection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.